Consider the following quadratic equation, x minus 2 times x plus 1 equals 4. This is a very tempting question to give to learners here about quadratic equations, because the left-hand side is factored. It's a binomial times a binomial, and that's nearly always our goal, right? Yay, we're trying to solve this by factoring. Someone already did it for me. But that would be great if the left-hand side was equal to 0, right? Because then the 0 product property would apply. But the problem is the right-hand side is equal to 4, and so you might be tempted to be like, well, I'll just factor 4 then. But 4 has lots of different factorizations. You have 2 times 2, sure, but you have 1 times 4. You also have 1 half times 8. You have 5 times 4 fifths. That's another factorization. And so it's like, dang, yo, there's a lot of ways of factoring 4. This is what's so significant about 0. This is why we use the 0 product property, is that when it comes to factoring 0, there's essentially only one factorization, 0 times something else. Who cares what that other thing is? For any non-zero number, though, the factorization gets a little bit complicated. So in this regard, if we want to solve this quadratic equation, we have to destroy the factorization we have. We have to kind of tear down the old empire to build the new one here. So FOIL out the left-hand side, you're going to get x squared plus x minus 2x minus 2 is equal to 4. Combining like terms to put it in standard form, we're going to get x squared minus x. I'm also going to move the 4 to the other side, so we're going to get minus 6 right here. Unfortunately, this is a monic quadratic equation. The leading coefficient is 1. So I'm going to look for a magic pair, and that'll give me the factorization. I need factors of negative 6 that add up to be negative 1. 6 does factor as 3 and 2, which differ only by 1. So let's make sure we get the sign in the right spot. If I have a negative 3 and a positive 2, then negative 3 times 2 gives me negative 6. But negative 3 plus 2 gives me a negative 1. There's your factorization. And then your solutions will be 3 and negative 2. So you might be tempted to say the solutions are like positive 2 and negative 1, but nope. We need to put this thing into standard form before we factor it. Because the right-hand side was not 0, we really can't benefit from this factorization whatsoever. So I don't want you to be tempted by this one. Just having a factorization is not good enough. The factorization needs to equal 0. If the product doesn't equal 0, we can't use the 0 product property, and there's no such thing as a 4 product property or a 7 product property. It needs to be the 0 product property.